Today in this video, I'm going to show you how to apply for NATA exam using your computer. So this video is sponsored by Bapni School of Architecture in Chennai, one of the best performing college in the Chennai zone.
In Google, type nata.in. So click on the first website. Now click on NATA 2022 registration button. So this is the login portal for the NATA application. If you are already registered for the examination, you can directly type your email address, password and the security code and click on the login. You'll get into the application portal. Whereas if you are the first time coming for registering for the NATA, click on the sign up button on the top. Now type your full name. Now type your father name. Type your mother name. Type your mobile number. Type your valid email address which you are using. Now select your date of birth, year, month and date. So next type your Aadhaar card number. For getting into the application portal, you need to give your email address and password. So for creating the new password, these are the guidelines. The password has to be between 8 to 13 character long, and also password must have at least one capital letter, one number and any one of the special characters that are shown in the window. Give a password satisfying all the mentioned criterias. Next, in the second tab, type the same password just for verification. Next, in case if you forget your password, you can recover your password by answering this security question. So select a question which is very familiar for you. Now give an answer that you will never forget. So next, enter the security code that is seen on the right side. Next, click on the sign up button. So this is the login credentials for your application form. Now go to your email account. So if you have successfully registered, you will have received a mail from NATA. You'll find all the login and details about your application form here. Now you need to verify your email address. For doing that, click here. Your email address has been successfully verified. Now click here, type your email address. Now type your password. Now enter the security code that is seen on the right side. Now click on the login icon. So we have successfully created the ID password for the application portal. Now we need to fill more details in the application form. So the first step in the NATA application form is basic details, where you need to give your personal information. So now we need to select this category, cash category. Check with your parents and give any one of the following category which you belong. So if you are a person with a disability, give yes, otherwise no. So gender, male or female or trans, a nationality, Indian, OC, you can give any one of the option. Now click on the save and continue button. So the first step is completed. Now the second step is address and exam details. So fill in the communication address details, your residence, Indian or overseas, secondary address, place of residence, rural, suburban, urban, country, state, you can type the first letter of your state and go to that option. City, same here, pin code, so landline number is not mandatory, you can leave it. So the next heading is select exam. For writing single exam, choose any one of the exam in the first row. For writing two exams, choose any one in the second row. For writing all the three exams, choose the third option. My advice would be writing two exams, so I'm going to choose any one of the option here. So next is exam shift, whether you want to write it in the morning or evening based on your preference. Select, now click on save and continue. So the next heading is educational qualification details. For this, you need to have your 10th standard and 12th standard mark sheet with you before you start filling the form. These three headings are already filled, so those are basic eligibility. Fourth option, board name. For CBSE students, you can choose Central Board of Education. For Tamil Nadu and other state board students, look for your state name in the list given. So for Tamil Nadu State Board of School of Education in Tamil Nadu, so look for your particular state if you are a state board student. For Central Board students, you can choose CBSE, Central Board of Education. So year of passing the 10th standard, you can give this, since it's 2022, it will be 2020. Now give your obtained mark, how much mark is the total exam conductor, then percentage will be automatically calculated. Enter the roll number that is given in your mark sheet. Enter the school name where you have studied. enter the PIN code of the school. So next comes the details of post 10, that is 12 diploma or anything. So education qualification, it's already pre-filled. Past status appearing, you can give like past if you are completed in 2021 or before 21. If you are going to write in 2022, give appearing. Go stream plan 10 plus 2 or diploma. So next is whether you are being, yes, this is mandatory for school students. Whereas if you are a diploma candidate, Max is a mandatory subject. So it's already pre-filled. So board of university name, where you studied your 12th standard. Same here, if you are a central board, choose CBSE. If the 12th standard is other state board, look for your state name here and choose. For example, for Tamil Nadu, it's State Board of School Examination, Tamil Nadu. So I'm going to choose Central Board of Secondary Education, Delhi. So institute name, school name, and then PIN code of the school locator. Next, click on save and continue. If you haven't filled any details here, you will get a pop-up like this. Please select the passing year. So here I haven't specified. So this is 2022. Now click again on save and continue. While filling the application form, if you want to do any changes, you can navigate between the tabs here. Right now we are in the step upload photo and signature. So before uploading the photo and signature, you should make sure that you have all the photo, signature and the ID document, identity, any one of the following ID document ready in JPG format. The instruction given here for uploading the documents are photo document size should be between this memory and signature has to be within this memory and the file name of the document should not have any special characters. So also Aadhaar card and the identity document has to be in the JPEG format and it should be less than photo and document size. It should be less than 100 KB. So you should keep the things ready. If you don't know how to do this, we have already made a video on how to reduce the size of the photograph and make it ready for the uploading. So the link for that video is there in this video description. If the photo is ready, just click on choose file and click on this one. Here I have a special character in the name, so I'm going to rename this photograph. Right click, just photo. I have my photo, signature and Aadhaar card here, which I am going to upload. For uploading the photograph, click on choose file, select the photo and click open. So the photo is uploaded. For signature, choose file, click on signature, open. The valid ID document from the government, I am going to upload my Aadhaar card. Here you need to fill your Aadhaar number. And next click on browse. The document also has to be in the JPEG format. Click on save and continue. So the fifth step is application preview and submit. Here you can see all the previous four steps are data are given here. Just verify whether all the details you are provided are right. My application has no errors. So I'm going to go down and click on save and continue. So last and final step is declaration and payment. So click on this check mark and click on any one of the following payment gateway. This is not the bank, this is just the payment gateway. When you go click on any one of the gateway, you'll get to pay money through any banks. So right now I'm going to choose ICICI Bank and click proceed to payment. So for the application, two exams, I have filled general and it's 4000 rupees. So I'm going to click OK. Now we are inside the payment gateway. We can pay the fees using any one of the following payment details like net banking, debit card, credit card. UPI is a very preferred method nowadays, so I'm going to use this. BPI is the UPI ID. So I'm going to give my UPI ID. After that, click on verify. Now click on proceed now. So you have 3 minutes to accept the payment in your mobile phone, either Google Pay, Paytm or any UPI application. So once you accept that, your money will be reduced from your bank account and the application will be successful.
In Neram classes, we have an online class going on for both NATA and JEE Paper 2. Students who are looking forward to score good mark in NATA and JEE Paper 2 can definitely enroll for this crash course. For joining the class, we have an application form in the video description. Do like, subscribe, and if you have any doubts, you can leave it in the comment section. So signing off, Architect Hari from neramclasses.com.